In this video, I'm gonna show you three different ways to waterproof your valley and explain to you which one's best. Did you know there are three different ways you can install valleys and flash valleys on a shingle roof? I wanna show you all three, explain to you the differences and how to properly install each method. Now, all three methods are approved by shingle manufacturers and are allowed by National Roofing Contractors Association and pretty much all standards. It's really just preference on which one of the three that you like. Let me show you how to install all three different methods. At the end, I'll give you my two cents on which ones I like. Now let's get into each one. At first, I'm gonna show you how to install open valleys, valley flashings. Then we'll get into cut valleys. At the end, we'll look at woven valleys. Then I'll give you my two cents. Valley flashings, or the open valley, is a great way to waterproof your valley. You can see here's the valley flashings that we use. It's called a W valley, is a correct term. It's 24 inches wide, which is California code. Some people do use 18, but 18 is not recommended, does not meet manufacturer specifications, and does not meet California building code. So what this valley allows us to do is install the shingles, leaving a proper gap. It allows the water to come, hit this ridge right here, and flow down the roof just the way we want it to. Valley flashings come in four different finishes. They come in the charcoal finish right here, which is a dark gray. They come in a brown, a white, as well as a galvanized finish. There's other custom valleys available, like copper and other materials like that. But generally, one of these three pre-finished valleys is what we recommend. These will last over 50 years, so they'll outlast your roof and keep your roof waterproof for years to come. All right, we're ready to start installing our valley metal. Now, before we installing our valley, we want to have our underlayment installed. You can watch in our previous videos, we have our ice and water shield installed already underneath our underlayment. So we've got our ice and water shield directly on the deck. We've got our drip edge installed. We've got our underlayment on top of that. We're going to install our starter shingle. Then install the first row of shingles, essentially right here. Now, I'm not gonna nail this for right now. We'll go ahead and nail this later. Then we wanna place our valley, and we wanna come out about 2 or 3 inches. Now, depending on where you are and how you want the water to flow. In this case, I want the water to flow out instead of going in underneath my undershot. So I would prefer to have it out about 3 inches. Now we can mark the top of the valley, get it cut prior to installing. Now that we have our valley cut, we're ready to start installing it. So we want to align to where we need in the bottom. In order to install it, we're going to be using a nail gun with the electro galvanized nails, same nails that you would use to install your shingles. You want to place nails every 12 inches on center. Now, the important thing is to make sure to nail at the outer edge of the flashing as opposed to anywhere inside. You want to leave the flashing as a nail-free zone. So you want to minimize the amount of nails that you have here so that any water that gets up here has no chance of coming and dripping through a nail hole. Now that we have our valley installed, we're going to be installing our first piece of shingle. Now, we do this a little bit differently, and this is a technique that we like to use. We believe it just gives us a lot cleaner of a look, and our finished product is nice and neat. What we do is install a shingle vertically with the valley. Now, first thing we want to make sure is install or leave enough of a gap between the W valley and the edge of the shingle. Anywhere from 1.5 to 3 inches is totally fine. If you have a smaller valley, 1.5 is sufficient. If you have a long run, 20, 30 foot run, you want to use a wider gap in order to allow for proper drainage. Just like other concepts in roofing and shingle roof installation, this channel right here is going to allow the water to freely flow and it'll minimize debris buildup, so you won't have leaves or things clogging up the valley. It's a nice clean metal channel for the water to flow down freely. Now, installing the shingle, we want to nail directly on the sure nail strip, and I'll show you the reason for that. Now, when we nail on the sure nail strip, that aligns perfectly with the edge of the flashing. So that ensures that we're not too far in. The sure nail strip, I'm gonna show you another example right here, is aligned with the edge of the flashing. So that's the way we wanna see it. The next step is to actually start installing our rows of shingles. One advantage to doing this way is we have the adhesive tab on the back of the shingle. this adhesive tab, when put on the metal flashing, creates a great bond. So on a hot day like this, within an hour or so, all those steel tabs are gonna melt and adhere to the valley, making it very difficult to lift up. Now that we have this vertical shingle installed, we're ready to start installing our regular runs. So we're just gonna align the first shingle up, make sure this corner is touching, then start installing. Now for this example, we've cut the shingles in half, just because it's a demo roof, but generally you would have your full shingles going across your roof and continuing. Now one thing you wanna keep in mind is, usually our shingle offset, we wanna do it, if you watch a shingle video, 5 to 5.5 inches between each shingles as far as the stagger goes. So just depending on your pitch and how steep your valley is, you're gonna have a different review here. So you might have to cut the shingles to continue your standard pattern across the roof. Now one thing you wanna keep in mind is you wanna minimize the nails in the valley. So actually the previous shingle I nailed incorrectly, you wanna nail it at the edge of the valley flashing. So you're gonna be right around here. So there you have it. You can see here we've got a nice clean line. It makes our job as installers faster because we're not cutting the shingles. And however clean you try to cut it or however straight, you never get a perfectly clean straight line as you would in this installation method. Now before you get started with a cut valley, you wanna make a determination on which side is gonna be your primary slope. And the way we like to do it is the roof that's larger is your secondary slope, because you can imagine the water is gonna come down here and you wanna make sure that the water does not get underneath that cut valley. So this will come up first, this roof right here. It is a lower slope, it's also preferred. It'll come up first, then we'll cut these and this will come on top. At the end of this explanation, I think you'll get a better idea of what that is, but that's an important consideration you have to make and it has to be thought out. Now we're gonna get started with, first off, the starter shingles, then get installing these shingles on the main primary field right here. Generally, we wanna go up 12 inches past the valley center line. Now in this roof, we might not have 12 inches, which is fine, we can go all the way. But if you have a larger slope, you wanna go past this valley center line, 12 inches. All right, now that we've got our primary field installed, we're not gonna go all the way up just for this tutorial. We're gonna show you what we need to right here. A few things I wanna point out is, number one, you can see that we've got our staggered pattern already laid out. What that allows for is ease of installation when you're going that way. And on this side, on the valley side, it ensures that each shingle is going up all the way. That 12 inches that we're talking about, we're achieving just because we're starting at a higher point, going all the way up, then staggering them to make sure that our shingles are shifting with the valley. The other thing I want to point out is that your nailing pattern on this side is not important, because once we start installing shingles on this field, we're going to be fastening these shingles down, so we're not worried about that. And we also want to make sure that we're not installing nails near the valley center line. So we want to be out 12 inches from the valley center line to our first nail to ensure that there's no chance of leaking here in the valley, and we're not putting penetrations where we have the most amount of water. Now, one detail that we like to use that varies a little bit from other roofing contractors is, prior to installing our shingles on this side, we like to install a piece of shingle that's parallel to the valley, Now we want to come up from our valley center line about an inch and a half to 2 inches to make sure we allow for proper water flow in this channel right here. Now what this shingle is going to allow us to do is a few things. First off, that adhesive tab that's on the back of the shingle is going to adhere real nicely down and ensure that this shingle is not going to lift up. The other thing it's going to do is going to provide us with a real clean finish. Anytime you hand cut shingles, you're never going to get a perfectly straight line, but this is going to allow us to get a nice clean line and have a really aesthetically pleasing finish. Alright, we're essentially done with this valley already. Obviously, we would continue this all the way up on a real roof, but for this demonstration, you've seen what you need to. You can see the few details that really matter is leaving a little bit of a runway here, a 2-inch, 1.5-inch space between your valley center line and the edge of this shingles. This is going to allow proper water flow and down. And you can also see that we use a full piece of shingle, and you can see the clean appearance that this provides. I think it provides for a real nice finish as well as for a great waterproofing detail. Now for our woven valley, we already have our starter shingle installed, which you want to make sure you have in place. We're pretty much going to start weaving these shingles in. So we're going to install our first piece right here. And don't mind the used shingles, this is just for a tutorial. One thing you want to make sure is you're going past your valley center line, a minimum of 12 inches on your back end. So right here is what you want to see. We've got 12 inches right here. And now what I would prefer actually to do is, prior to installing this piece right here, I want to install this just so we pass this corner right here, which is our vulnerable area. Now remember, you want to come past your valley center line. So if this is your valley center line, we're coming 12 inches past that. We want to make sure we're not nailing it in the valley zone. So I usually like to leave 8 to 10 inches from the valley center line with no nails. All right, now we're gonna install this shingle right here. Again, valley center line, 12 inches past the valley center line, and we're ready to install. Pretty simple, again, just making sure we don't nail it right in the valley, because this is where the primary water is gonna flow. Now, as we're laying our shingles, the easy way to keep this 12-inch overlap, as well as make your job easier moving forward, is to leave this staggered pattern right here. So that way, when we're continuing the roof, we've got our 5.5 inches here, and that makes it easy for us installing the valley. So that's pretty much it. You just continue the same pattern all the way up your roof. Now, pretty much at this point right here, when you're close to about 12 to 16 inches from your valley center line all the way to this edge of the shingle, you want to restart with a full length and pretty much restart this pattern coming all the way up. All right, so now that you've seen all three valleys being installed, I want to give you my opinion on which one I like, which ones I don't like, and in what application I like what type of valley. Now, before I get started with that, again, I just want to mention that all three are approved by manufacturer specifications. So it's not like one's right or one's wrong. Every roofer has their preference, and really every homeowner also has their preference, because a lot of this has to do with aesthetics. Let me start off with the valley flashing, the open valley system. The limitations on that is a few. First off, if your pitch is really anything greater than 8/12, you're gonna have difficulty bending that valley. So you're gonna either have to be forced to get a custom valley metal fabricated, or go with like a cut valley system, which I personally prefer for steep slope roofs. And you're also limited by the type of colors that are available on the market. So as I mentioned in the video, off the shelf, it comes with browns, charcoals, which is like a dark gray, a white, and galvanized color. So sometimes people install different color roofs. Let's say a green tone roof, or a beige light tan roof. You're gonna have difficulty matching the valley flashing color to that roof. So if you do have a unique color, I recommend going with either a woven or a cut valley, and not going with a valley flashing. Now, if you do have valley flashing installed, it works great on really any roof under 7/6/12 pitch. And if you like the appearance of it, I think it's a great flashing detail. It looks generally pretty clean in my opinion. Even though you do have that break in shingles, that valley flashing comes pre-painted, so that paint's gonna last you like, I don't know, 10, 20, 30 years. I've never seen paint peel off. So that pre-finished material is gonna last you for a long time. Now, the next type of valley that we looked at is the cut valley. This is personally one of my favorites. I generally like to either go with an open valley, valley flashing system, or a cut valley. The nice thing about cut valley is it does match the rest of the roof, so you're not introducing a valley flashing. And also looks clean and has a super straight line if done properly. So really, I don't think there's much to say here. Really on a 4/12 to, or 2/12 to 6/12 roof, I think the difference between a cut valley and an open valley is pretty much the same. It's user preference, so whatever the homeowner likes, that's what we like to go with. Lastly, the woven valley. Now, I'm always gonna say this, I don't like the woven valley. I think it looks messy, it looks ugly. It just has a staggered pattern and doesn't have any clean lines. I personally don't like it. I think if done properly, it'll last you, it'll do waterproofing properly, it'll, you know, waterproof your roof, which is the primary function of your roof. But the second most important thing for me is the appearance of it. I don't think it looks nice, that's why we don't install it, we don't recommend it. In the last 10 years that we've been in business, we might install it once or twice based off customer preference, or if we're doing a repair, we'll match what's there. But if we're installing a new roof, we don't like to use that method. Now, you've heard my opinion, tell me yours in the comments below. How do you like to do your valleys? What do you like and what don't you like? Love to hear from you.